Here you gotta be somewhat liberal.
No.
No?
No, I'm left wing. Liberals are not left wing. Liberals are fucking centrists who want to protect the status quo.
Well, I don't identify with most liberals.
I don't identify with any liberals.
Yeah.
Admit you suck. You should get rid of that question mark.
Just be a Christmas song just based on cheerfulness alone, right? Yeah. Alright, we're gonna do a Christmas tune for you next. A tune that I think you probably know well called God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen. Actually, it's God Rest Ye Merry, Gentlemen, which no one knows. But that's what it is. Except how many of you have heard it before as a samba? So dance along with us a little bit here as we get ready to do a little God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen. We'll be right back.
summer here. I hope it's not. Dad has not been with us.
Oh, yay, I remember two routines.
Thank you. So by fighting for 15, you're making the results of everything you're fighting against more harm.
Okay, I got it.
Students.
Okay. I know. Lost your train of thought?
I'm trying to follow what the point is here.
Both sides are right.
What's your point?
I don't think you're trying to follow Jack shit.
Not talking to you.
Yeah, too bad. You choked me. We've got what you call beef now on account of you choking me with full force, with intent to kill. And the only reason you released your grasp was someone cracking you upside your head. Remember that? That's why my finger's broken, from trying to break your grip. But I couldn't, so kudos to you. And it was after you went on a tirade about women having inferior upper body strength to men. And then you showed your superior upper body strength, right? By trying to choke me out.
By defending myself against a weaker person.
Your little fucking flag. Oh, I took your tiny little fucking flag.
You initiated force.
Ha! You are a clown.
Yes. But you're the funny one.
Tell me someone reported that shit.
So there are 3.5 million homeless in the United States. I think that number is probably low. What defines a homeless person?
No, I know, right?
I'm homeless. Are you?
I live on that road, but I'm still homeless.
I'm sorry, Brad.
I'm a Native American.
I wasn't.
How long have you been homeless for? You were homeless since before you were born. Well, then what hope is there?
You seem like a
new hope. We change the system, no, because otherwise
you won't be.
I don't mean to sound like a jealous type, but you are.
6 years. 6 years of my life, 6 years of the past 8 years of homeless. Working a lot of the time, working two jobs, but homeless.
In Portland here?
Not in Portland specifically.
Where have you found yourself homeless?
California.
And then because that wasn't working out for you, came up here to Portland then?
Yeah, well, actually I came up here to Portland more to join the activist community because it's more activist. But it's also better, but because of that, that's why it's not a massive working homeless population like in California. Because in California, there's massive amounts of working homeless because they don't stand up enough for the rights.
Have you thought for a second that maybe you're homeless because you're gravitating towards the activist community?
That is not the case.
Do you have a skill?
What's that?
Do you have a skill?
A what?
You have a skill. What's your job? What do you normally do?
I work in the fields. I also work in warehouses. And I've got many years working in the fields by day and in a warehouse by night, having only a few hours of sleep at night. And often by, what's that? Cauliflower, bok meat, lettuce.
That's hard work. In the sun, not easy.
Yeah.
A lot of immigrants do that work, don't they?
Yes.
I detect a little bit of an accent. Are you from originally another country?
Well, my mother grew up as a missionary kid to Papua New Guinea. My grandfather was a missionary to Papua New Guinea, and my mother grew up. My mother was born in Michigan, grew up in Papua New Guinea, back here as a teenager. Well, that says a lot about how bad it's been in the past. It doesn't say that it's actually good right now. Any unemployment is a problem. In Cuba, there's no unemployment. There's no one's homeless in Cuba. No one goes hungry in Cuba.
Cuba?
And there isn't any unemployment. Everyone has jobs in Cuba. And we need a system where everyone has jobs. We need a system where the working class, where people who are working are not in the streets. I'm not going hungry.
You said your example was Cuba?
Yeah.
Communist Cuba?
Yeah.
How's that working out for the Cuban people?
It's working out quite good. Here in the U.S., 120 million working class people and their children go to bed hungry every night. 2 million working homeless, including a lot of chronic working homeless. In Cuba, there isn't any working homeless. No one goes to bed hungry.
That's because everybody gets paid the same $27 a month. Everybody gets paid the same $27 a month. That's why they're not hungry, but they're certainly not happy because they haven't allowed freedom.
The people in Cuba are happy. I actually know a lot of Cubans myself.
Is that why they make treacherous journeys over the ocean to come here?
Well, a few people who basically are part of a rich and don't want to, want to basically be able to take advantage of others, push others down in order to make money as office people will come over here. But the vast majority are staying there. Actually, in Colombia, there's like 12 million people have fled Colombia because of its capitalist system. That has not happened in Cuba. The media will, the corporate media will play up anyone who basically leaves an equal system. But anyone that leaves because of massive inequality and starvation, the media will have a complete blackout and won't even mention it.
Are y'all trying to co-opt the civic nationalist movement for communism?
Yes, I can answer that.
We're asking for wages high enough that the working class can eat and stay out of
the
street.
You know the Yellow Vests are a civic nationalist movement, right?
Right now, the richest 1% have $17 trillion, while 2 million there's 2 million working homeless, 120 million working class people, and the children of people working.
You understand what happened,
go to bed hungry every night.
I was standing right next to Jesse Sponberg when he shut down the ports, Terminal 6, during Occupy Portland. Then that eventually, that movement ends up leading to the ports closing, ends up leading to a shitload of great paying jobs, trucker jobs, longshoremen, etc., being pretty much abolished because Hanjin pulled out. Leads to a ton of people that can't afford their rent,
yes,
leads to homelessness.
But, that
you
know
offer socialism to slightly decrease
the
their
only
misery.
Way rate has ever brought ever stayed up was through protests and unions, and when Reagan made it harder to protest and harder to have unions, wages stopped going up with inflation, and the inflation was started being much faster than the wages and increased inequality. The reason you guys are against it is you don't want equality.
Don't
so
tell us what we're for
make
against,
it
please.
Sound like
don't tell us what we're for
it.
Against.
I'm ashamed to see you.
We can change this, and we will be here.
Shut the fuck up.
What are you here for then? If it's not conversation, what are you here for?
Right.
What are you here for? Are you trying
what
to
are you
kill
here
me
for?
Again? My finger is still broken.
I'm always here for conversation. I'm always
you
here for discussion. I'm here for debate.
No, I heard Yellow Vests are here and came and a bunch of fucking commies are here.
Now they're pretending like they want to work. They don't want to work.
I have a job.
We all
I worked
have jobs.
Literally 14 hours yesterday. I'm not lying.
Good. Good for you.
Well, you're acting like it's something to herald above somebody else.
Do you have a job?
Yes.
What is your job?
Why will we tell you where the fuck we work? You gotta insult us.
No, I'm not asking where you work. I ain't telling you where I work.
Okay, exactly.
What do you do?
You said you wanted to be part of the activist community.
Artist.
You said you were unemployed. And this guy said he's been
I'm
an unemployed,
unemployed artist.
So the fuck
I have
you
my own
know
business.
What systems of oppression
if you're
are?
How's good going? Enough, then you're surviving, right?
This is not a meritocracy, though.
What is it?
What's the issue?
Yes, it is. That's what capitalism is. It's a result of freedom.
No, capitalism is where the rich, lazy office chair class hoards millions of dollars while the working class starve in the streets. I've been working two jobs the majority of the past 8 years and homeless the majority of that time.
That sentence doesn't make any sense.
Yes, I've been homeless the majority of the past working homeless the majority of the past 8 years, working two jobs the majority of that time, 100+ hours a week.
Not about that.
You're houseless. Where are you from? You have a home. You don't sound like from here.
I'm homeless, and I've been homeless six of the past 8 years, working homelessness for the past 8 years.
Excuse me. Y'all just got my hopes up. I thought the actual yellow vests were around and I come find
it's
a
bunch of populist.
What do you think about the yellow vest movement in France?
The real total civic nationalist movement. You see they're raising their country's flag. They're protesting the United Nations overtake of all the countries.
I heard the generals are going to try Macron for treason now.
And Macron's throwing on a yellow vest to try to seem like he's part of the party.
Oh.
Yeah, I just did that
yesterday. The irony is thick.
But, yeah, I got to tell you, I'm a little disappointed.
Yeah, well. I don't think if there was a yellow vest movement, it would start in Portland.
No shit, it didn't start, you dipshit. It's already been happening. Could you kindly fuck off?
I'm working on building a working guillotine to bring to the capital, but I think we might have a difference of opinion on who will end up writing that.
Well, freedom. Freedom.
Damn shame.
Always goes freedom in that Constitution.
It's the Bill of Rights.
It's the thing that guarantees our freedom. It's the thing that fights against fascism.
Running these guys off the corner.
Who's freedom?
The people of this country.
A bunch of slaveholders fucking wrote that. Fuck off kindly, fascist.
The people of this country are free because of that document.
I got no problem with you. I've known him for years. My finger's broken because he tried to choke my ass.
You don't know me at all.
I don't talk to pigs, so he didn't get arrested. He was sweating. You know they were talking to you.
You initiated force.
Bullshit. I touched your tiny little flag, sir.
That's initiating force.
Because difference of opinion, you rank property above people.
Says who? Says you?
Your actions over the past 3-ish years that I've seen you.
Well, property is an extension of personhood.
To you.
No, to the Constitution.
This is a difference
to the Constitution.
Of opinion.
The laws of this country.
As I said, I give no fucks about what a bunch of slaveholders wrote. That's my opinion.
I'm not telling you
to put down your Bible, put down your Constitution. I'm telling you don't fucking choke me out.
Yeah, I'm telling you, don't initiate force against me, and I won't have to defend myself.
So, are you against the Fifth Amendment for protection?
No, there are good things carried out by the Constitution. There are noble aims. I'm saying something being sourced from the Constitution is not alone enough to validate it for me. Such as Wikipedia could be a starting point for research, it's not a source.
It is a source.
No, it's not. If you go to a college course, it is not a valid source, actually.
Directly contrary to what the yellow vest movement started
with. I think I stated my stuff as succinctly as possible. Now I have to go to work.
If you're not part of a yellow vest movement,
do some physical labor for probably over 12 hours.
I am, but I'm not putting
enjoy yourself.
In standing thank solidarity
you.
With a bunch of communists.
Why don't they just get out of it?
I am part of the movement. You're not part of the movement. You're pretending to be part of
it's
a movement
because
you see something bigger than yourself.
They're not smart it's enough to come up with anything on their own, so they have to steal everybody else's good ideas.
Yeah, but where does it start?
Where
does it start?
With a conversation with us.
If nobody doesn't do nothing, then where does it start?
I mean,
are you going to start
problems.
It?
Okay, so
the
where's this? So,
totally around
with so it starts with ideas. It starts with the ideas. So let's
the right has decimated the
union. I'm a smart person. I'm not trying to prove.
What are you trying to prove, man?
What are you trying to prove? I'm not the one out here with the sign.
I don't need to prove nothing.
Well, then why are you standing aside wearing a sign?
All on communism. It just...
I don't need to prove that I'm as smart as you.
I don't
think you're smart.
It doesn't matter. All I'm doing is questioning the sign that you're holding. I want to learn more about what brings you out today, except the only thing I can do is read.
What brings me out is that people. What brings me out is that a lot of people don't do nothing about all the corruption, about all the capitalism, about all the thievery.
Well, corruption and capitalism are two totally different things.
Yeah, but still, it's a bunch of thievery to me. So if anybody's going against the thievery, I'll go against it.
Capitalism is.
So you're a victim.
Doesn't matter if I am or not.
Well, you're.
It's still a bunch of thievery.
So
conquer, when you
from?
Say conquering my country, that means you came over here and stole it.
It wasn't a country.
So if anything's going to go against that, then I'll be part of it.
The land of Native America wasn't a country before it was settled.
It doesn't matter if it was a country or not. It was something that we owned. We were here.
Define ownership. I didn't think Native Americans believed in the idea of ownership.
Yeah, you're part of the thievery, though. That's what you're trying to say. That's what you're trying to say.
What have I stolen?
That's what you're trying to say.
You're accusing me of stealing something?
Yeah.
What did I steal?
Yeah, everything you got belongs to us.
Oh, so I should just get everything I have.
Everything you got belongs to us, man.
Well, here, have my bike then. If it's yours, take it.
Thank you. Don't come back for it either.
You're not taking my bike. But my point is not. You're proving my point. You gave it back because you know it's mine. I didn't steal it. I've earned this. Just like I wouldn't take your vest.
I thought you would cry for it.
Well, I'll get the bike back one way or the other. I promise you that, buddy.
Oh, yeah?
My problem is I don't understand what you guys are here for.
You got a problem with me?
I'm just asking about your sign. And you're saying that I'm a thief. Am I a thief? What would I do about it? I don't initiate force, but I can defend myself.
If you get your boy, you do.
If you don't break the law, you have nothing to fear from the police.
That's why you write the laws to protect yourself.
No. You write the laws to protect everybody.
Well, you protect yourself with it. That's what you do. That's you stand around like you're brave or something.
Like I'm brave?
Brave because you got your cops standing around watching.
No, I'm brave because I'm not afraid.
Watching from everywhere.
I'm brave because I'm not afraid.
Why are you hiding your medals then?
Do you want to see them?
Put them out, man. Show who you are.
This is who I am.
Yeah. Show. Stand out and show them, man. Don't hide them around.
I am me. I'm an amalgamation of all my experiences, as you are.
You're hiding around under that suit, man.
I'm not hiding, I'm standing in full front. No mask, open conversation, willing to expose my ideas to yours. I'm not afraid.
What said you to be afraid?
The police, they think that I should be afraid of you guys.
Really?
They asked why, they said, how are they letting you get so close to them? I said, why would that matter? Because they don't like you. Is a person defined by who they don't like? I don't think so.
Just think it's me that you got a problem with.
I'm sorry to hear you.
You got a problem with me, don't you?
I have no problem with you. I got a problem with bad ideas. For you. I'm full-blooded American.
Well,
it's
not
a legitimate
here,
nation. It was colonizers, and they fucking stole it and genocided it and broke treaties and stole it from the native people. So it's not your country.
What's
and I'm a white person, too. It's not my country.
Right,
I'm willing to discuss
here,
any one of those points.
I'm willing to discuss any one of those points.
There's nothing to discuss. If it's stolen and genocided and ripped from people, if I steal your
okay,
bike
there's
from
three
you,
things there.
That's not legitimate either. If I take your shit, it's not legitimate.
No, it's a violation
this country
of property.
Was taken.
Right.
So it's not your country. It's not mine either. Don't walk around with such a sense of entitlement.
Who owns
to fucking debate
you?
Stupid,
go around and steal everything and then try to make money off of it.
Like what?
Everything. Trees, water, everything.
Uh-huh.
All the kind of people like you that want to do all that.
Like me?
All that.
What do you mean like me?
It's natural resources. We've finally established energy independence. So we don't have to go to wars to kill brown people in Arab countries.
Isn't that a good thing?
This is a good thing.
All the natives end up being the poorest people on the whole continent because of all that.
You think that's the cause?
Capitalism.
You think that's the cause?
What?
What's the cause of that? You
the thievery. The thievery. Coming
the
over
thievery.
Here and stealing my country. Yeah, that's the cause of it.
I disagree with the premise that land was stolen if it was not owned.
Your ancestors stole it.
My ancestors?
Yeah, where you come from?
Where did I come from? This country. I was born here. Just like you.
Native Americans believe that nobody could own the land.
Oh, every time you capitalize on something, it's taking it from people that are homeless.
Taking it from people that are homeless.
Yeah,
that sentence doesn't make sense.
Thank you. On the land.
That was written in a book written by a white man. That's one of those books that they used to make themselves feel better about the being guilty, about what was going on. You're killing millions and millions of Native Americans.
Yeah.
Now they write those books up so you guys can read them, and then you won't feel so guilty about what you did. What's going on?
What did I do? How can my grandfather immigrated from Poland when we needed jobs.
You can't feel guilty over something you had no part of.
It's still going on. Look it up.
How? Where?
In your books. Where
what
you
books? What books? Show me the book. Give me the title. Who said
that? Come on. We've got a library over there.
I think you got to go to a communist bookstore for these books.
Ah, son of Hightower.
We'll sit around over there.
I notice you're not wearing a yellow vest this time.
I don't have a yellow vest. It's an orange vest.
I was looking for it. That's why I'm here.
I was going to say, they call out the movement.
That's an orange vest. That's a good friend of mine. How are you doing, buddy?
Pretty good. I'm doing all right. And down here, I was kind of hoping to see a yellow vest.
All that stuff. Then we won't be down here. Crazy yellow vest. The homeless people.
Hey, dude. Don't trip.
What?
You're gonna get that sign broken if you fuck with me. Thank you.
directly funds the wars in Central, South America, North America, the Middle East, and Africa. The rich is responsible for the blood of billions. They profit off our blood.
Your boss is stealing from you. you.
Your boss has neon from you.
Keith Ledger can laugh better than
you. Yeah.
Boy over there, man. Those dudes over there, we're ripping their ass every day for us. So I think that's fun.